Hi everyone. So in this video, some shocking information I'm going to tell you about, because a lot of students are asking, and I see a lot of emails. So some important things which you must know before uploading your documents. Okay, your last date for uploading the document is 16 June till 5 p.m. After 5 p.m. any kind of emails, any kind of request, any kind of trials should not be entertained by the joint admission committee. You must keep these things in your mind. Like after 16th 5 p.m. no such kind of request will be entertained. It is already mentioned in the website. Okay, so this video is important for those who are 3 to 4 things which is very important I am going to discuss. First of all, I want to discuss those who are message me or those who are text me regarding the like marksheet issue, 12th marksheet issue. So some of the student asking, bhaiya, I completed my class 12th in 2024. I got some percentage like this, and this year I have already I take improvement. So will I upload that marksheet? Will I upload a 2025 marksheet or 2024 marksheet? Okay. Secondly, the frequently asked question like, bhaiya, I have class 12th marksheet, but I got one compartment in a subject. So should I upload the marksheet or should I upload the declaration form? So these two to three things generally ask in the comments about the marksheet. So first of all, I must recommend you, for those students who are appearing in class 12th in 2024, if your percentage above than 60, like more than 60, if you got, then I think there is no issue, and this year you take any kind of improvement and improvement result is already declared, then you will upload that class 12th marksheet for 2025. This is my opinion, and if you are not, then please keep things as it is, your 2024 marksheet. And one more thing I must recommend, please, before doing any kind of action, before taking any kind of action, please rectify or please notify to this joint admission committee. You should mail, and maybe there is no reply in 2 to 3 days, but you should you have two options: either you mail, either you call. First of all, you mail and tell about this query. I am passed out of in 2024. I have this marksheet for improvement like this. After that, if reply comes, then it's fine. If it is not came, you will try to call between 2 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. on working days. It means Monday to Friday, you are allowed to call 2 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. 3.5 hours you are allowed to call. Otherwise, generally you have to mail in. Also, if you want to quick reply, also you have to mail between 11 to 5:30 p.m. You will get response. Okay. If you response in midnight, then a lot of people are mailing, right? So if you midnight, then you will mail down in as for the sequence. So I recommend you first you notify to the joint admission committee, I am doing these things, should I have facing any kind of issue or not. If they are allowed, then it's fine. But I don't think so. If you already cross the criteria of a percentage regarding 60%, those who are from general EWS and OBC and OBC NCL category, 60%, and those who are from PWD and SC and ST category, 55%. If you already cross this barrier, then I don't think there is any issue. But for your clarification, for the satisfaction, because see, why are you taking risk like for 0.1%? Why are you going to take any kind of risk? So for safety reasons, you just make this. Okay. What next doubt is, bhaiya, I am taking compartment. So I in this situation I am not able to say anything. You have to, you must have to. In previous case, like for the improvement, I was appearing in class 2000, I appearing in 12th 2024, in 2025 I am appearing for improvement. This case is very different, but this case is you are appear in this year, also you get a compartment, so you are going to for the re-exam. So I must recommend you contact with joint admission committee through the call or through the email. If emails is not come, just send the reminder between 11 to 5:30 p.m. 11 to 4:30 p.m. okay, just send the reminder, because these query only shorted by the joint admission committee. If I suggest you, you are like you upload your class 12th marksheet and after that some issue will be created, then you blame me directly, right? And you blame me directly, and second thing is you are in the trouble. Your whole hard work and your whole year is waste, right? Like if someone is scoring 144 marks and by this kind of bullshit mistake and this kind of silly kind of mistake, like he didn't get call any college. Last year one case this will happen, same case this will happen. Okay, so contact the joint admission committee. I know the reply will be not very frequently, because you also try to understand. Some of the students ask the question very very natural, very simple question they directly mailed. Okay, they cannot use the common sense, then they directly mailed some. I heard 2 to 3 days before some student mail to the joint admission committee when the result will be announced. See what kind of question this is. Seriously, you are going to mail to the authority, like joint admission committee is kind of a body, kind of a cell, kind of a authority. A lot of people are in the group members, so you directly mail to the jack and asking when the result will be announced. So this is very obvious question na, ki, because in April there is a mention in the website your result will be on 10 June, but after some time the date like 10 June will be disappear. That's reason why, because a lot of students are not filling the class 12th marksheet, that's why again the window will be reopened. So I already make a video in today morning, either result will be on 10 June or after the 16th of June after completing the selective document upload window. Okay, so I think this doubt will be clear. Your second doubt is a lot of students are asking, bhaiya, I have been 60% in class 12th in like 60, no, not for the marksheet, not for like. Some of the students are asking for the category certificate. I am appear in like my category certificate is valid from 25 April 2024 to 24 April 2025, so it will be considered or not. No, strictly no, it will be not considered, because that certificate valid up to that day on 2025, uske baad to wo hai hi nahi, uski manyata hi nahi hai. It will be not considered. You must have to apply for after 1 April 2025, tabhi to 1 April ke baad ka manga gaya hai. So after 1 April 2025 you must have to upload. If you are not applied, today is 2nd of June, you must sit on the website, open the YouTube and try like see the process, how to fill, how to apply for the caste certificate. You have applied already, and if you have any contacts regarding this, then you can use the contacts. In a week or after a week, approximately 10th of June, you will get the soft copy of that certificate. And if you get the soft copy, then you go and upload. After getting the soft copy, maybe 10 to 15 days, you will already get the hard copy of that. when the time of counseling, you get the hard copy and show it. I don't think there is an issue. Second thing is, income certificate doesn't play any role in the counseling. Don't worry about things. One student asks, "Bhaiya, income certificate is allowed for asking, like income certificate is used in the counseling or not? When, how can I apply?" Income certificate is no need to worry about these things, because income certificate doesn't play any role in the counseling. And third the most asked question in the comments as well as in the text messages. So question is that, bhaiya, I am not only one query regarding these issues. I see a lot of queries regarding this. In this case which I am going to discuss, this case at least I see 4 cases regarding the same issue. Student saying, bhaiya, I am uploaded a class 10th marksheet in place of photo ID. So in this case, you must have to notify the joint admission committee, sir or madam, I will by mistake, I will upload a class 10th marksheet in place of photo ID card. Okay. And if you asking for my opinion, you don't have any trouble about these things. I think you didn't face any issue regarding this. Okay. Because class 10th marksheet is also used for your photo identity card, because your name is mentioned, your photograph will be mentioned. Okay. And also in the Aadhaar card, your name and photograph will be mentioned. And these things only used for whatever the application form, your name and your date of birth and your photo. These 3 things verify by the photo ID. Okay. If you uploading class 10th marksheet, I don't think, and in terms of percentage, I am 95% to 98% surety. It would not create any kind of issue for uploading a class 10 marksheet, but for safety reasons, you must notify the joint admission committee and see what will they say. I don't think there is any kind of issue. And one more thing, if you have an option to change it, then you can change. You must have to upload Aadhaar card. Okay. And again, I am repeating, please make sure that for the next time you don't do any kind of mistakes like this. I already told in my previous videos, but most of the people are not taking seriously. That's why in the starting, every video in the starting, I am saying please watch the whole video, because in the midterm, in the mid end of the video, I told. Like I mentioned some points which are going to very helpful. Okay, but people doesn't take seriously, and after that they are in trouble. That's why today you are asking these questions. That's why I am making this video. I totally understand what's your situation and what are you thinking in your minds. But don't worry about things. I am with you, and I pray and I wish you all the best. You all are get your dream college. So don't worry about these things. Whatever steps I am mentioned in this video, please go and watch. Okay. Bye bye. Take care. And tomorrow, one more video is very important. BTech course curriculum. I am going to present you how the BTech course curriculum is going on for the chemical engineering student, for the data science and engineering student, electronics and communication engineering student, and data science and computer science and engineering student, because 4 branches in offered in BTech. First is chemical engineering, second is electronics and communication, third is data science and engineering, fourth is computer science and engineering. So these 4 courses, these 4 branches in BTech are offered at IISER Bhopal. So tomorrow's video is very important, so please make sure subscribe this channel as well as follow me on Instagram for your convenience. any kind of update, any kind of official update. I'm not going to waste your time regarding like by making the video any kind of spam, any kind of unknown things. Okay, I'm just provide a official update, so don't worry about these things. Please subscribe this channel, because your support is very very important for me, and your support is motivation. If you want to join as a membership, I already announced a membership in my channel, and it is very cheapest, approximately 49 or 59 approximately, the minimum price is 49. Okay, so if you want to join, if you want to connect me directly, then you should. And I plan to launch the one-to-one call session or one-to-one reply session on my WhatsApp. So those who want to connect on my WhatsApp, please let me know on the comments, and in few days it will be going to announce. Bye bye, take care yourself. I again wish you all the best. You all are getting dream college. If you have any doubt, please let me know on the comments box, and feel free to ask any other way, like email, Telegram and Instagram also. Bye bye, take care.